All right, let's play first. Oh, that last round is still brutal. Ooh, this hand is so good if I draw green. Yeah, this hand's fine. I'm definitely not tilt-keeping because of last round. That would make no sense. But if I do draw green mana, this hand actually just goes off really well. Also, if I draw Mana Crypt and just play a turn 2 Coercive Portal, that would be great. So, yeah. Something like that. Mana Tithe? Really? Mana Tithe? Oh, why me? Alright, let's play a Swamp and pass. Probably gonna draw like Woodfall Primus next turn or something. That would kind of be justice. Swamp, okay. Well, Swamp means I'm like well on my way to casting Coercive Portal. Regardless of what happens here. Mana Crypt, how lucky. Alright, what do you got? Did they have a turn 2 Coercive Portal? Sneak attack's interesting. If I draw a red mana, I could start sneaking things in. See if my opponent wins the Mana Crypt flip or not. My opponent won the flip, how lucky. And they're gonna vote for not blowing the world up. I'm gonna vote for it doesn't matter. They draw an extra card every turn. Alright, see you. What do they got? Well, this looks like a good hand. Tezzeret? What's Tezzeret going to seek out? Search library for artifact with converted mana cost, X or less. Seek out like a mana rock of some kind. Could just untap Mana Crypt if they want a plus Tezzeret, but that's not super exciting. I'm dying pretty hard. Alright. Here goes the Mana Crypt untapping. Oh, and they have a play, a Golgari Signet? Oh. Alright. I am off it. Getting crushed here. Let's see. Let's take out Masker Worm. Let's put in Duress, I think. Alright. Good. We solved it. Alright. I would like to play first. Yes. Yes. This hand's great. Turn one. Entomb, turn two, exhume. Put it world of six. I even actually have good follow up. I think I'm supposed to just get a Woodfall Primus, but we'll see what my opponent does on turn one, I suppose. Yeah, if they just go land, go. I assume that's better. Then I can play Liliana on. Three. I could also Liliana myself to sacrifice to persist the Woodfall Primus if I really wanted to. It's in tune. Yeah, well, it's definitely not Sunring Titan. I could Emrakul, but I'd rather just Woodfall Primus, I think. Do, do, do. Yoink. And yoink. Alright. Yeah, I actually think there's a good chance that I'm supposed to Liliana myself here. Ooh, Survival of the Fittest. Well, I guess that doesn't change what that much because I can't use it this turn. So let's go Badlands, Liliana of the Veil. Mm-hmm. Sack Woodfall Primus, it comes back. Humph. Just Stone Rain my opponent every single turn. If I draw a land, I can to hit slime in a few turns here. Ooh, Orzhov Signet. Actually, that does do the tricks. Now I can go plus Liliana, discarding on burial rites. And then next turn, I think I can play Orzhov Signet. Then next turn, I can on burial rites back the acidic slime after plusing Liliana again. See what my opponent's got. Nothing so far. Let's. Plus. Unburiates the slime ball. Sweet. It only took a great draw. But I did get there. All right, what do you got here? Ooh, the potential for a turn two Course of Portal. I'm going to keep this hand. If I draw any land, I have turn two Course of Portal. Also, I have Shallow Grave, Animate Dead, which I guess aren't really a combo. More like I have some reanimation spells. Also, a random Ember Cool hanging out. All right, Mountain Sea, perfect. Land go. We have another temple, and that is fine. Well, my mana situation isn't great here, but I do have turn two Coruscant Portal, and I can cast Zealous Conscripts with any land, and I just need to draw some black sources to cast my other things. No, oh, Jace. Okay. Well, Conscripts are good against Planeswalkers, as it turns out. I'll go with Tails, I win the flip, very nice. And let's see what we can do here. Ooh, Acidic Slime. I guess I can't cast Acidic Slime off of Arid Mesa. So, you know what? I actually think I'm just going to get Badlands. I'm going to play Conscript. Even if it doesn't kill Jace straight up, I get to draw an extra card here. I think I'd rather just draw an extra card. And then attack my opponent for three. Then they have a Jace in play. If they want, they can kill off Jace to draw a card. But my hand is so good, I think that me drawing extra cards is great. Then again, I always think that. Now my opponent has to deal with Conscripts if they want to protect their Jace. And then now I can play Liliana. Overgrown Tomb. Where'd that come from? I guess it came from the Marsh Flats, but still, Overgrown Tomb. Oath of Druids? What? Okay. And then Jace dies. Sure, that's fine. Let's go ahead and draw a green source so I can just cast this Acidic Slime. That's not really what I meant by a green source. I lost the flip. Weak. What is my opponent going to oath up? I don't know. Do I care? Yeah, I guess I kind of do. Let's just go Liliana. And sack Conscripts and just pass the turn and not play anything into Oath. The reason I'm doing this is I actually have a kill next turn if my opponent taps out of plus one Liliana, discard Emrakul to Promised End, Shallow Grave, Emrakul, attack for 13. So, not introducing the variance of my opponent oathing up like something wild seems like it's going to be great here. So they just need to tap out for a not flyer. There aren't very many instants that can stop Emrakul anyway. I guess even if my opponent doesn't tap out here, I'm probably just going for this. Yeah, Tezzeret's not going to do it. Tezzeret can fetch out like a Signet or something. I guess it can fetch out Mana Crypt. I don't know. Ye old Tezzeret Oath deck. Tezzeret in for three. Coalition Relic, maybe? Oh, Basalt Monolith. Okay. As long as I don't pick the wrong portal. Tails, I won. I've been doing well on Mana Crypt flips. Draw an extra card. Plus Liliana. Discard Emrakul, the Promised End. And Shallow Grave. Whoop! Turn the top creature card to your graveyard to the battlefield. Gains haste and exile at the beginning of the next end step. Deal 13 to you. Kabam. Not exactly the way we drew it up, but I guess it'll work. Alright. Send in Emrakul, the Promised End. And not at Tezzeret the Seeker. Also, there's protection from instants. There really aren't very many cards my opponent could play here that would, stop this from finishing the game off, I would suspect. I was getting moderately close to casting Emrakul. A few more turns. I'd have 7 mana, and I could probably get like 5 or 6 types in the graveyard pretty easily. Humph. Alright. we're 1-1, though that heinous error in round one cost us, but hey, if we win our last round, we can redeem ourselves a little bit, just a little bit.